We hebben heel veel mensen die van het buitenland komen, die bij internationale organisaties werken in Den Haag. En wij Hagenaars zijn er trots op dat we ze in onze stad hebben. Maar we moeten een beetje meer contact met elkaar hebben. Daar is de Haagse Brug voor. Al die mensen van, zoals zij het noemen, de international community en de gewone Hagenaar met elkaar in contact brengen. Dat is de bedoeling.
The Hague Bridge project allows The Hague to access its urban districts. In the next few years, working closely with residents' associations, schools and the international community, several activities will be organised, all geared towards stimulating contact between The Hague citizens and the city's expats.
The Hague Bridge has been conquering more and more districts of our vibrant city. Eskamp was the most recent neighborhood to join the tour.
Eskamp is natuurlijk een ongelooflijk groot stadsdeel. Als je het is een stad als Gouda, met het Zuiderpark ook daar in het midden. Wij, zoals we hier zijn, Eskampers zeker, met ook trots over het gebied waar je woont, wil dan vervolgens ook aan die international community laten zien wat we ook in dit stadsdeel in huis hebben. And we hope that the Hague Bridge here in Eskamp will be a success like it was in the other parts of our beautiful city, the most beautiful city we've got in the Netherlands and the most beautiful city in Europe anyway.
Eskamp is mijn stadsdeel, ik voel me hier thuis. En ik hoop dat iedereen die van elders komt zich hier ook thuis voelt. Ik ontmoet ze graag met open armen.
This is a very impressive project as it's building bridges between cultures.
Haagse Brug draait om stadstrots, dus laten zien hoe mooi Eskamp is aan iedereen. Het draait om de internationale stad van vrede en recht dicht bij de mensen te brengen. En het gaat erom dat we mensen van allerlei culturen met elkaar verbinden. Nou, dat gaan we de komende maanden doen. We hebben een poster. Moet je eens kijken wat een mooie poster. En daarvan krijgt u er eentje mee. En ik hoop dat u die tegen het raam plakt. En dat is ook een teken dat u ambassadeur bent van de Haagse Brug.
Je laat je inschrijven met je naam, dus je voornaam en achternaam en je foto. En dan ben je geregistreerd.
Ja. Even in de lens kijken.
Kids from the 8th grade of primary school went on a discovery journey through the tales of the Hague's Humanity House. In the Humanity House, they learned about how they could alleviate risk situations.
Citizens of The Hague are instructed to leave the house immediately.
Waar gaan we naartoe?
Het huis verlaten, want er is oorlog uitgebroken.
Je weet nu ook hoe mensen zich hebben gevoeld, zeg maar, in die tijd. En hoe het is om te vluchten.
On February 1st, one of the coldest days of the year, the Hague Bridge took local residents and expats on a walk through the Zuiderpark.
30, 40 years ago, especially people from Suriname and India, they had on Saturday afternoon and Sunday afternoon, they showed each other their birds. Birds in those cultures is a very big thing. And one of the people showing his birds had too many. And he just thought, I'll get rid of them and they will die eventually.
Whatever district the Hague Bridge participants get acquainted with, a walk through the area usually does the trick. There's fresh air, it provides a relaxed way to get to know each other, and there is lots to see.
Dit is ook om andere mensen te leren kennen. Dat vind ik hartstikke leuk.
To top off the excursion, everyone was invited for a sneak preview inside the brand new City Hall District building.
This is one of the things I'm very proud of to be part of, having realized this building in this neighborhood, in this area. Our city, The Hague, loves international organization and the people working over there, but we also want that people being a part of the city. They maybe stay for a few years, but they must not stay stranger.
One of the most unusual visits that the ESCOMP district enabled was that to the largest fire brigade of The Hague.
Nou, als het goed is, krijgen jullie een korte introductie van ons. Achter ons staat de autospuit, daar wordt uitgelegd hoe dat in elkaar zit. Binnen lopen mensen met maskers op, geblindeerd. En een andere collega die vertelt hoe het gebouw in elkaar zit van ons.
The literal peak of this trip was the possibility to get on the lifting ramp.
Hoe hoog? Het was 25 meter.
Oké. Okay. Was u niet bang?
Nee. Nee, dat niet gelukkig, want dan heb je het niet goed natuurlijk.
Nee. Yes.
How was it? What did you just do in there?
Yeah, we were just looking for checking this room inside. So, and we found the body. So it was completely, looks like you are in smoked room. So there is, you cannot see nothing, so absolutely.
The visit made it clear that in case of calamity, clear cooperation between people of different nationalities is essential.
And I think it's quite important that we speak the same language. So in case of emergency, I don't have to speak Dutch or English, so we will understand each other. It's not just interesting, it's we need it.
And then something happened. Although exciting, it did mean the end of the excursion.
I'm just quite excited, you know, to see, you know, it's the first of a big international organization I'm going to visit.
The excursions to the largest international peace and justice organizations were more than a success. The Hague Bridge provided unique access to the buildings that are usually off limits to the public.
Chemical weapons also have characteristics which make them particularly dangerous. The fact being that it's quite easy to manufacture a chemical weapon. You don't require a great technology. You don't require money, and this is one of the main dangers that is represented by chemical weapons today.
Both natives and expats from ESCOMP were inspired by these professional and high-profile work environments. The OPCW, the Yugoslavia Tribunal, the International Criminal Court and Eurojust. There was no lack of applications to attend these trips.
But today I found out that Eurojust and in Europol, they are separate organizations, but working together for crime prevention, terrorism, prevention of trafficking and drugs.
These kind of activities are so invaluable because they create transparency and openness and participation, but from the public at large. And I strongly recommend that The Hague in the future engages its population in ways like this and make it happen.
The Hague Bridge is really a symbolic bridge for everyone. At het Haags Vak College, British and bilingual high school students debated on the meaning of diversity during a mini conference on the topic.
Well, first we had breakfast just to meet all the new people from like the different schools, and we got to know each other and just talked. And then we came here into the hall and watched a short video about diversity.
And this is diversity in practice. This is what we in The Hague mean with it being an international city of peace and justice. This is bringing together students from Dutch schools, from the international school, and let them discuss what it means to be a very diverse city, what they can learn from it, what the value for them is.
We were split up into groups, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and 7, I think. And we had to talk about diversity, your identity, and your connection, and think what it meant to us. And then we had to do a short presentation on it in front of everyone.
If you had to say one thing that you learned today from this morning, what would it be?
We're all different, and it doesn't matter. And also to make it okay for us to be different.
I didn't really realize how I'm connected to my friends. Then I just realized that school connects friends.
Yeah, we just get to know each other very well, so it was pretty fun.
You had a good time, huh?
Yeah, it was nice.
At the Guldenhuis, many countries and their traditions were represented during the cultural fair. The fair was opened with a warm word of welcome by the alderman in charge of the district.
Diversity is a strength. En dat blijft ook wat mij betreft de komende jaren voor deze stad gelden, dames en heren. Er zit zoveel kracht, denk ik, in die expatgemeenschap en dat benutten wij onvoldoende. Wij benutten dat onvoldoende, maar ik vind dat ook expats hun verantwoordelijkheid niet altijd even goed nemen om de kracht van onze stad en vooral de kracht die in wijken en in buurten zitten, om dat goed te benutten. Ik sprak net iemand, een vrouw van een ambassadeur, en die zei tegen mij van deputy mayor... Ik ben voor het eerst in mijn leven ben ik op de Haagse Markt geweest. Ik heb daar toch zoveel leuke dingen gezien die ik gewoon in het Statenkwartier niet zie, waar ik dus op dit moment woon. Nou, dat gaf natuurlijk een enorme band tussen mij en haar, omdat ik juist probeer te promoten dat de hele stad probeert te genieten van onze Haagse Markt. Have fun and please challenge each other to get connected, because that's the main issue today, I think. Thank you very much. Tot ziens, tot gauw.
Vanuit Guldenhuis hebben wij de visie al heel lang om werelden met elkaar te verbinden. Wij zetten onze deuren open, niet alleen voor de mensen in Eskamp, niet alleen voor onze bewoners en onze bezoekers, maar eigenlijk voor heel Den Haag en zoals vanmiddag bijna voor heel de wereld.
Ja, nou, ik heb gewoon zelf een brede interesse in mijn eigen stad. En ja, dat is een mooie manier om in aanraking te komen met partijen waar je anders niet zo gauw voor mee in aanraking komt.
The more you meet the local community, the more you integrate and know their culture, know about them. So it's, I mean, you're in somebody's country, it's good to know about them and interact with them.
En de brug brengt je samen, dus ja.
There were many stalls with sometimes exotic products and skills demonstrations. One of the day's highlights was a beautiful Moroccan fashion show. All in all, it was a wonderful afternoon that put a lot of smiles on a lot of faces.
It's knowing each other's cultures. That's what makes you do this, right? Because again, if it's why do you behave or react in that way, if you don't understand each other, that's where you miss. So I think the cultural side of things, the social side of things, understanding each other, that's the key.